Hi, my name is Cooper. I'm a math teacher and a data scientist, and I love to talk about math and statistics. Let's talk about probability. First, what is probability? When we talk about the probability of an event occurring, what exactly do we mean? Next, let's go over some of the basic rules and techniques for calculating the probability that an event will happen. Finally, we'll work through a few examples. Probability can be thought of in a few different ways, but generally, you can think of probability as being the chance that a specific event will happen, usually provided either as a percent or a decimal between 0 and 1. Probability shows up everywhere in our lives. From the moment we wake up and check the weather, what is the probability that it will rain today? To the time we sit down and watch the football game, is the kicker going to make this field goal? So, how do we calculate the probability of an event? There are a few basic rules to keep in mind, but before diving in, let's get a couple of things straight. We'll denote the letter E or some other variable to represent the event we want to know the probability for, and P of E to denote the probability that the event will happen. For example, E might represent the statement, it will rain today. And P of E would represent the probability that it will rain today. Number one, the 0-to-1 rule. As previously mentioned, probability will always be between 0 and 1. This is because if an event can never happen, it has probability 0. The probability of rolling a 7 on a 6-sided die is 0, since the highest number you can roll is a 6. If an event is guaranteed to happen no matter what, then it has probability equal to 1. For example, the probability that the sun will rise tomorrow is 1, we hope. Another example of this rule can be seen with a standard deck of 52 cards. What is the probability that a card we choose will be a rectangle? Well, this is just a regular deck, so the probability is 1. All the cards are rectangles. What about the probability that a card we choose is a circle? Again, since this can never happen, the probability is 0. Number 2, the counting rule. Most of the time, the probability of an event can be calculated by finding the total number of ways an event can take place, and then dividing that by the total number of possible outcomes. This rule works well for things you can count, like cards in a deck or numbers on a die. However, this concept of repeated experiments doesn't really work for things like predicting the weather, where we rely more on information about the environment. Back to our deck of cards. What is the probability that a card we choose from the deck will be a heart? Well, we need to know two things. How many ways can we choose a heart from the deck, and how many total possible cards we can choose? Since there are 13 hearts and a total of 52 cards, the probability of choosing a heart is 13 divided by 52, or 0.25. This is how the counting rule works, and is really the backbone for solving a ton of probability questions. Number 3, the complement rule. The probability an event occurring is also equal to 1 minus the probability of that event not occurring. For example, what would be the probability that we choose a card and don't get a heart? Well, one way is that we could count all the possible ways of not getting a heart. This would be all the clubs, all the diamonds, and all the spades. But there is another way to solve this. We can use the complement rule. The probability of not getting a heart is just 1 minus the probability of getting a heart. And since we already know getting a heart has a probability of 0.25, we can say the probability of not getting one is 1 minus 0.25, which is 0.75. This is a pretty simple example, but sometimes finding the probability of the complement of an event is a lot easier than solving the problem directly. And in these cases, this rule can be very helpful. Number 4, the AND rule. The probability of two independent events happening at the same time is the product of the probabilities of the individual events. In other words, just multiply the probabilities together. For example, let's say we have two different decks of cards, and we pull one card from each deck. What is the probability that we get a king from the first deck and a spade from the second deck? To be successful, we need both events to happen. So this is an AND question. Since pulling a card from one deck has no effect on the card we pull from a different deck, it's safe to say these events are independent, but it's always important to check. So, the probability is just the product of the individual probabilities. Using the counting rule, we have 4 ways to get a king out of 52 cards, and 13 ways to get a spade out of 52 cards. So the probability of doing both is just 4 divided by 52 times 13 divided by 52, which equals 0.02 approximately. Keep in mind that this only works if the two events are independent of each other, meaning that one event happening has no effect on the probability of the other event happening. Number 5. The last rule we'll talk about is the OR rule. The probability of either one of two events happening. This is the most complicated of the basic rules. It is equal to the sum of the probabilities of the events happening minus the probability of them both happening. So, what is the probability that we choose a face card or a red card? This uses the OR rule. So we need to find the individual probabilities as well as the probability of both of them happening to answer the question. So, since there are 3 face cards, the Jack, Queen, and King, and 4 of each face card, then the probability of getting a face card is 12 divided by 52. Now, since half the cards in the deck are red, the probability that we pull a red card is 26 divided by 52. So when we add these together, we get 38 divided by 52. But wait, there's a problem. We counted the red face cards twice. This is why we need to subtract the probability of a card being both a red card and a face card. The Jack, Queen, and King of both hearts and diamonds are all the red face cards. So we subtract 6 divided by 52 from 38 divided by 52 to get 32 divided by 52, or a probability of 0.62 of getting either a red card or a face card. Notice that we could have also answered this question using just the counting rule. How many different ways are there of pulling a red card or a face card? Well, all of the red cards would result in a success, and there are 26 of those. Then there are an additional 6 cards that are not red, but are in fact face cards. So we get a total of 32 ways to succeed. Divide this by the total number of cards in the deck, and you can see we arrive at the same answer. Probability questions like these often allow for different strategies to solve them. Go with the strategy that makes the most sense to you. Keep in mind that if it seems difficult or tedious, there might just be a faster way. The 5 rules can be summarized this way. The 0-to-1 rule, the counting rule, the complement rule, the AND rule, and the OR rule. Different people might call them different things, or have a different set of rules that they consider to be basic. But with these 5 rules, you'll be well on your way to solving a plethora of probability problems.